While the Coast Guard and the Marquette Fire Department both maintain that all ice is unsafe, they recognize that people are still going to go out on it.
When going out, you want to be prepared. You want to check the weather, make sure the ice is thick enough. You want to have a good couple inches. You want to make sure it's been below freezing for quite a while.
If the temperature has been above freezing and there's snow on the ice, there's an added hazard, air pockets. These air pockets are the result of the ice thawing, creating a crevice, and then freezing over again. These spots are much weaker than the surrounding ice and can be easily hidden under snow.
That snow keeps the ice warmer when it warms up, and it can insulate it, and you won't know what you're walking on. So just be aware of that when you go out. It may look thick, it may look strong, but there's a good solid chance that there's going to be some weak spots in there.
There is an advantage to going out on ice-covered ponds or small inland lakes, even though the surface still could crack or break.
That lake, you know, is only a couple hundred yards across, maybe a mile, and there's not a large body of water. If a piece of ice breaks, it's not going to float out. Lake Superior and the harbors on Lake Superior, if any of that ice starts to break up or waves start forming on the rest of Lake Superior, those ice chunks are going to float out with you on them.
If you do decide to go out, whether it be on a pond or Lake Superior, you have to take some necessary precautions.
Have someone with you, never go out alone. When you do go out, you want to let someone know that you're going out, where you're going to be, how long you're going to be. Also, you could have a marine radio or a GPS tracker. You want to have the proper gear. You can have ice picks if you fall in to help pull yourself up.
Screwdrivers and life jackets are also effective tools to help you if you fall in. If you witness someone fall through the ice, call 911 immediately and let them know exactly what time the person fell in. This is especially important because responders use a rule called the 1-10-1.
First one stands for you have 1 minute to catch your breath. That's for the gasp reflex when you hit cold water. The 10 stands for 10 minutes of meaningful movement. So you have 10 minutes to either try to get yourself out of the ice or get yourself stuck to it. Get your hands on the shelf or your clothing and get it frozen to the ice. That'll prevent you from drowning. The other one is for about an hour of consciousness after you're in the water.
After you call 911, don't get too close to the person because you risk falling in yourself. Reporting in Marquette, I'm Alyssa Lambert for ABC 10 and the CW5.